Hi friends, welcome back to another YouTube video. In today's video, I'm actually starting the series where I am going to be solving some LeetCode SQL problems as well as Python. And I thought it would be a good idea for me to kind of do it on the camera and record my screen so you all can watch me while I'm doing it. And hopefully you get to learn something in the process. If you learned something from this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you want to hear more about data science, tech lifestyle, career journey, and everything else in between. Now I'm going to actually start with LeetCode. I don't have a premium version on the LeetCode. I have the free version. On the free version, there are a few SQL questions that are available with different difficulty levels. So what I'm trying to solve here today is medium. The first one video that I posted, I solved an easy problem and some of you wanted me to do medium and hard problems. So let's do that. I think the easy one was way too easy. But I'm sure like some of you people who watched it, they obviously learned something from it, especially if you're new to SQL. So in today's video, we're going to solve three medium LeetCode problems. If I run out of problem on LeetCode, I will jump to HackerRank and try to find intermediate SQL questions. All right, with that, I'm gonna hit record on my screen and we can get started. I just went into LeetCode and on LeetCode, so I clicked on problem and then I went on to databases because databases has SQL related questions. So I clicked here and now I'm gonna pick one problem. I think majority of these are SQL. So I'm gonna change the difficulty level to medium. And then from here, I'm gonna pick one of the problems and do it together. All right, so this one looks fun where we have to find, it's problem number 176 under databases, second highest salary. So let's click into it and solve it. So let's read the problem first. The problem is basically there's an employee table. So ID is the primary key, primary key column for this table. Each row of this table contains information about the salary of them, of an employee. Okay, makes sense. The problem that they're giving us is write and SQL query. Is that good? Is that proper English? Write a SQL query. Is it write a SQL query? Oh my God, TMI. All right, never mind. Write a SQL query to report the second highest salary from the employee table. If there is no second highest salary, the query should report null. Okay, let me just think about it. So they are, let's say the company has employees and the table has employees and they want to find the second highest paid employee. Okay, the query results is in the following example. They gave us example, which is, this is what it looks like. So there's basically ID, I'm guessing that's employee ID. And then the output is basically a single digit output. What is the number of second highest salary? So amount of second highest salary, okay. Then example two is basically employee table and then output is zero. So basically when the employee is, when the table, when the results has only one row, which means that there is no second, then they want the null. Okay, let's try to solve this. Let me just say it out loud what I think that this wants. This basically sounds like, since we have only one table, there's no join, but from within this table, I just need to find the second highest paid person. And just by the sound of it, it sounds like it's going to be an analytics function. The part that I'm not sure about is either it's a row number or a rank or a dense rank function. So what I'm gonna do is like, I'm gonna try and see which one it is. Cause like this whole process of practicing is learning. So let's do that. All right, so what I need to do, first I'm gonna write my from statement, which is from employee table E. And then I'm gonna do my select. So select is basically the ID and the salary. And then I need that the analytics function that I was talking about. So that's what I need. My first instinct is to go with the row number. Let's see if that works. Like row number, is it row number or row number? Row number, it's row num. Okay, over partition by. So if, for those of you who don't know what analytics function are, they're basically a powerful way to analyze a large sum of data smartly. So it's not very difficult to learn, but think of it like you are doing your group by statement, but doing all of that in one line of code. So think of it like a group by, but in a more smart fashion. So if you're not familiar with the analytics function, like I would highly encourage you to get into that because that's pretty much what it is, like intermediate and advanced SQL. is like working with analytics functions. So get used to that. Okay, so for partition by, this is where I need to think. So they want the employee. So we only have two fields in the table. So what I'm gonna do, partition by ID, because that's what I want to segment by. That's what I want to segment. And I want to segment it by salary. And I want it in that descending order, so DESC. So descending, which basically means that I'll have the highest salary and the ID next to it. All right, so I'm gonna call it as RN and I'm gonna run it. This is probably not gonna be the right answer, but I'm gonna run this anyway and see what I get. There is an error from the right syntax. I think this is supposed to be this. Run code. Okay, so the function, the row num, it was row number because I'm using MySQL. Seems like the answer is wrong, but there's no syntax error in the code. So let's look at the error again and see what is actually wrong. So my input was this. The output that I'm getting is, I'm getting ID and row number. So 1, 2, okay. It seems like it's, I think what is happening is since I am partitioning by ID, it's partitioning the ID first and then the salary. So it's ranking the ID, it's putting the row number on the ID. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna remove this and I'm gonna run this again. Let's see. This works, order by salary descending. And what I get. Okay, now at least when you look at the output, now at least I'm getting the order correct. So the highest salary is getting 1, 2, and 3, but the values that they're expecting is 200. So what I need to do is basically have another select statement outside of it. So I'm gonna say select salary as the second highest salary, which is, I'm gonna copy paste it from here, from this inside query, from this, and I'm gonna call it B, and I'm gonna limit it to where row number equals to 2. So let's see what I get here. So if I run the code, I should get 200, which is the second highest salary. Okay, well, looks like that is the solution. Basically what I did is I used the row number function and assigned an ID row number to each row that I'm getting for ID and salary. And the order I applied was descending. So it starts from the highest and then goes and low. And then I created an outer query around it where I basically pulled the salary information where with the filter row number equals to 2. So it gives me the second highest salary. All right, so that was good. So for the second problem, let's go back to LeetCode. Right here. Okay, so let's do the same thing again. We're gonna switch to medium and databases. Okay, so it's already there. So let's try to do one more. Let's do this one, rank scores, because this could be a good ranking exercise today. Okay, so for the problem number 2, what we have is a scores table. ID is the primary key for this table. Each row of this table contains the score of a game. Score is a floating point value with 2 decimal places. Understood? Write a SQL query to rank the scores. The ranking should be calculated according to the following rules. Okay, there are rules. Rule number 1, the scores should be ranked from highest to the lowest. Got it. If there is a tie between 2 scores, both should have the same ranking. So the third is, after a tie, the next ranking number should be the next consecutive integer value. What? After a tie, the next ranking number should be the next consecutive integer value. In other words, there should be no holes between ranks. Okay, that part I'm a little bit confused about. Okay, the return the results table ordered by score in descending order. Ordered by score in descending order. which is the query result format is the following example. So they want ID 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, score is this. And then the output is basically they're giving rank to each score. And okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna say from, I'm gonna write my from again. So this is scores table. Gonna call it S, and what I want to select, this somewhat seems similar to the last problem that we solved, but I feel like there is a catch that I am probably being on overconfident. I don't know if I'm what I'm missing. Okay, so select ID and scores. So this will give me basically everything in the table, but what I need is an analytics function to basically find the score ranking. So what I'm gonna use, actually, I'm gonna start with the ranking function, the rank function. And if that doesn't work, then I'm gonna try the dense rank. So rank over partition. So I don't know if we need a partition, but let's see the output again. So it wants score and then rank. Okay, so what I want to do is order by score, score in DESC, and I'm gonna call it as rank. So, and then I need to put an outer query around it, or do I? Actually, I don't. So I can remove this ID. So I need score plus rank. That's all I need, right? So maybe it can't be this easy, but let's run the code. Ready? 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, epic failure. Okay, there is a syntax error. Okay, you have an error in your SQL syntax. Check the manual test code, blah, blah, blah. Rank. Is rank not a function anymore? So the current MySQL server version for the right syntax. Okay, let me copy paste this into Oracle SQL. Let's see if this works. Okay, so apparently there's a different syntax for MySQL, which apparently I don't remember, but I basically copy-pasted that code into Oracle SQL and it seems to be working, but the answer is not correct. So at least I don't have to worry about the syntax error right now because it's all about the logic that I'm trying to improve on. So it's saying that, so this is my input and this is my output. So my output is value, ID, the score is 4 and rank is 1. The score is 4, the rank is 1. The score is 3.0. Okay. So I think what's happening is that it wants the consecutive rank, but here it seems like it's skipping the rank. So it goes from 1 to 3 and there's like no 2 here. So let me try dense rank because I know, because I, as I was saying, like one of them does do the duplicates. And so run. Oh, ta-da! Okay, so so basically dense rank was the right function to use here. What it's doing is basically looking at the score and going back to the score and basically assigning consecutive numbers to each. So here you can see like 4.0 and 4.0 is assigned 1. 3.8 is assigned 2, 3.65 is assigned 3, 3.65 is assigned 3, and then 3.5 is assigned 4. So awesome. I don't know, maybe I should move on to hard. Medium is not that, doesn't seem to be that difficult. Yeah, let's do the third one. So let's see which one I want to pick. Looks like this one I have solved already. And the rest of them, okay, so I don't have many options other than like these few. So let's do this one. Okay, so they have already given me this framework and I need to write it inside it. Okay, cool. So let's actually look at the problem first. So again, we have an employee table. The ID is the primary key column of this table. Each row of this table contains information about the salary of an employee. So write a SQL query to report the nth highest salary of the employee table. If there is no nth highest salary, the query should report null. Doesn't it sound like similar to what we did the first problem? The query results format is the following example. So this is the input, you get salary. And what is this, n equals to 2? I don't know what that is. Get the salary. Oh, so basically they're saying like if I say n equals to 2, then give me the salary. What is the second highest salary? The second is this. Honestly, like I think we did this one, but I'm going to do it for the sake of it because this might look intimidating for to some of you. So start with my base table. So I'm going to say from employee E, and then I'm going to do my select. So for my select, they are only expecting salary. So I'm going to pull both ID and salary, ID and salary. And then I'm going to say, row number. Why do I keep typing row num? Okay, row number over partition by, I don't think I need a partition. Remember from last time what we did? So I only need an order by because I don't need to segment it by anything. So I'm going to do a salary, then I'm going to do descending, and I'm going to say as RN or N in this case. So, and then I need to put a, I think that's pretty much it, right? Because there is a function around it that already is here. So, okay, return result. So the function is create function get highest salary n in number. Return number is result number. Okay, I'm gonna run this code and see what the error are, and then I'm gonna try to fix it. Runtime error. Wow, interesting. This is the first one I've gotten. There's no other thing. What? I feel like I wish I had music right now. Why is there a runtime error? Does anybody know? Come on. What am I doing wrong? I'm gonna copy paste this into MySQL. Okay. So create function get highest salary, n is an integer, which the function is gonna pass. And then return is, this is the return, write MySQL statement. So, oh, okay, maybe I need to do a wrap around it. So select salary from this table where I'm gonna call this table, this tell this table BB. Oh my God, I'm horrible with these names. So BB, so where N, which is what I'm getting, equals to BB, or I can just call it RN for the sake of it. Key equals to RN. So now I'm only gonna get this based on the N. Okay. I really hope that gives me, oh! What? Wow, that was so smart, Sundas, good job. So basically what it is they have a function to give you highest salary based on the rank that you input. It looks like I basically had to output only one number, and then my where clause basically is this information is getting passed in the function. So I say where n equals to this number, and then it gives me the one output, which is 200. So we did it, three problems, three medium SQL LeetCode problem. So as you saw, like the three problems that we solved today, most of them were around the theme of ranking. And I used primarily analytics function. I think in two of the problems I used the row number, and in one problem I had to use dense rank after trying the rank. If you don't know analytics function, I would highly recommend you to get familiar with them because they can be super, super useful for writing these complex statements in very short number of code, short amount of code. Short amount of code, small number of code, small number of code, less code, less lines of code. That's what I mean to say. Yeah. I hope like watching me practice, watching me do these problems, I hope you learned something along the way. Let me know in comments actually what you learned today. So with that, thank you so much for watching. I hope you're having a beautiful day, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.